Star Citizen storage, that is what this video is all about. We've got hard drives, solid state drives, Gen 3 and 4 NVMe, RAID, everything. Testing to see, is there any point in getting more than just a standard SATA SSD? Let's get into it. First up, we've got the solid state drive, just a standard SATA drive, it's a pretty generic one. We've got a third generation PCIe NVMe drive, and then also we've got a fourth gen version. And we're going to just load them into the same system, into the same server. I've got another computer which is already in the server, so they're all going to the same one immediately after each other, and they've recorded these results. We've also got Crystal Mark results, is kind of a benchmarking thing for storage, just to show you, in theory, there is a difference between these drives. It's quite a large difference, really. But will there be one in actually loading into the game? I've looked also at performance. I've done a look, 10 runs at least of each of these in Lorville, and just given an average. And as you see here, there's no difference in performance once you're in game. And I have done more than that as well, just in the other areas, there is just no difference in ports. So really we're looking at loading time. So here are the actual loading times, and you'll see they're basically all the same. There's no difference. And this is as scientific as we can get into the same server, same number of entities, all sorts of things going on. There's no real difference. Next up, we're doing a hard drive as well as RAID, which is using two of the Gen 4 PCIe drives together to get the maximum speed. And as you see from the Crystal Disk Mark results again, the RAID result in theory absolutely obliterates everything else. And obviously the hard drive is very, very slow, and that will play out. But the load times here, they've all been sped up. But once we actually get into the game, the RAID result is slightly quicker, 4 seconds quicker than the Gen 3 drive. And then the SATA one is a couple of seconds slower. Kind of a difference, not much of one. But then the poor old hard drive, we're just waiting and waiting and waiting. And this is all has been sped up significantly. But man, I was bored out of my brains. We finally get in game at 5:50, but that isn't the full story. We're in game, but then only this small portion of Lorville has actually loaded in. And we end up waiting an incredibly long time for the elevator and the rest of the city to actually load. Yeah, it's just not playable at all. 12:19 before actually it loads in, and then we can play. Here's the four of those ones again, shown against each other. The hard drive in the bottom right hand corner is the one to watch. It's just complete stuttery mess. It is unplayable. And I did a poll just before making this video to see what people were using, and a couple of people are using a hard drive, and I just don't know how. I don't know how they're doing it. I guess if you start the cities, maybe it's not so bad, but man, it is horrific. And this is my yearly warning: do not use a hard drive. So what to make of all this? Well, effectively nothing really has changed from what we've done in the past. I've tested this before and just proven that hard drives are a complete no-go, and we've seen that again today. Complete no-go, don't do this on a hard drive. But really, past that, there's no real difference between just a SATA SSD and then fancier N.2 PCIe 3 and 4. No real difference there. There's a small difference maybe in load times when you're talking about RAID, but the amount of money that you're doubling up the drives to get that speed for maybe 4 seconds of loading time, you can work out whether that's worth doing. I would say probably not. So there are applications where faster storage makes sense, but it's kind of generally been accepted for a while now that gaming just isn't one of them. And obviously there's things like direct storage coming maybe at some point, but we're not there yet for anything like that. And there's just no real point getting more than a standard such a SATA SSD. So there we go. We'll call that this for this one. If you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, please subscribe and like this video. You can join the channel now and support them that way. That's amazing. And that's enough. I'll see you soon. Bye.